Welcome to the 11th annual Dick and Tunkie Riley What Works South Carolina Awards Celebration. I'm Don Gordon, the Executive Director of the Riley Institute and Furman, and I'm delighted you're with us today for the celebration of the excellent work being done across South Carolina to support and enhance public education. Thanks so much for joining us today. I'd like to give a special welcome and offer congratulations to our three 2021 What Works South Carolina Award finalists. They are Bridges to a Brighter Future, Charleston Promise Neighborhood, and Reading Partners South Carolina. Finalists, congratulations to you all. We are delighted to have you in the spotlight here today, and we celebrate your great work. We have a wonderful program for you today. In just a minute, you'll hear greetings from two United States Secretaries of Education, our own Dick Riley, who served from 1993 to 2001 in the Clinton administration, and our current United States Secretary of Education, Miguel Cardona. A bit later in the program, you'll hear remarks from South Carolina Superintendent of Education, Molly Spearman, plus our own Kathy Stevens, the director of the What Works South Carolina Clearinghouse. Kathy's here to help us learn more about the initiatives of our three What Works South Carolina Award finalists. And finally, at the close of our program, Secretary Riley will announce which of our three finalists will receive the 2021 Dick and Tunkie Riley What Works South Carolina Award. Before I turn things over to Secretary Riley to introduce Secretary Cardona, I want to offer our sincere and great appreciation to the organizations that not only work in support of public education every day, but also have given financial support to today's award celebration. There are seven organizations whose generosity has made it possible for us to support innovative programs and to award $10,000 to today's first place winner and $1,000 each to the finalists. They are Riley Pope and Laney, LLC, the South Carolina After School Alliance, the South Carolina Association of School Administrators, South Carolina Education Association, the South Carolina Education Oversight Committee, South Carolina School Boards Association, and South Carolina ETV, who has created today's videos that capture the value and the spirit of our finalist programs. We appreciate their partnership so much. And now, before I turn it over to Secretary Riley to introduce Secretary Cardona, I want to take this opportunity to offer a special thank you to Dick Riley. Secretary, your lifetime of leadership has meant so much to our state, so much to our country, and certainly for the Riley Institute. Thank you for all you have done and all you are doing.
Thank you so much, Don, and thanks to all of you who are online today, certainly the finalists, and also everyone who has filed an application. The more people involved in this What Works program, the better it works. And we're all trying to lift up public works, public education, what really is working well. I think we all ought to take as many opportunities as we can to celebrate our educators, parents, teachers, students, especially after such a difficult 20 months. And I'm proud we're doing that today, and then you're all part of it. As Don mentioned, I served as U.S. Secretary of Education for all 8 years of the Clinton administration. Today, it's my pleasure and honor to introduce to you the current U.S. Secretary of Education, Dr. Miguel Cardona. Dr. Cardona did not come to Washington from a political career. Rather, he's an excellent career educator, serving first as an elementary school teacher, then as a school principal, and then assistant superintendent for teaching and learning. More recently, he was Commissioner of Education for the entire state of Connecticut. That's the top administrator in the state on the state level. On March 2 of this year, Dr. Cardona was sworn in as the 12th U.S. Secretary of Education. I really know from firsthand experience the broad and deep responsibilities of the nation's Secretary of Education. State's Commissioner of Education, I would point out, also carries huge responsibilities. made even more difficult in a global health pandemic. Dr. Cardona met these challenges strongly and effectively, never losing his focus on equity and excellence for all learners. So my friends, I'm pleased to enjoy words from my friend, the nation's U.S. Secretary of Education, Dr. Miguel Cardona.
Thank you, Secretary Riley, for the introduction and for your remarkable life of public service to your home state, to our nation, and to generations of learners of all ages. It's a great honor to share time on the program with you virtually. First, let me applaud Furman University's Riley Institute for leading this work. I also want to applaud all those being recognized for your support of promising practices that are based on data and evidence, especially at a time when students and communities are facing so many challenges. We need to share what's working. That's one reason why I'm so grateful for the Riley Institute. Dick Riley and his late wife, Tunkey, have been tireless advocates for improving public education, raising academic standards, making high-quality teaching and learning accessible for lower-income families, and expanding college grant and loan programs. This award celebration shows what's possible in service of students when we bring determination, innovation, dedication, and creativity to the work. And online resource hubs like the What Works South Carolina Clearinghouse are vital for sharing promising practices so that others can learn from them. All three finalists you're recognizing today are helping to inform policies, practices, and partnerships so that each child in each school in South Carolina is healthy, safe, engaged, and supported. Bridges to a Brighter Future, a college access and personal development program, has an impressive 100% high school graduation rate. Charleston Promise Neighborhoods proves that it takes a community to help a child succeed, providing under-resourced schools with professional development for teachers, field experiences for students, and school-based clinics for student health and wellness. South Carolina Reading Partners is helping close the reading achievement gap for children living in poverty. They're working to empower communities by providing individualized instruction that puts children on track to read on grade level by the end of third grade. In short, these finalists show what education can be when communities come together. Last year was among the most challenging the education community has ever faced. But I'm encouraging everyone here to redouble your efforts because this next year will be the most important as our country recovers from the pandemic. Thank you for helping to ensure that all students have the supports they need to be successful, especially in communities most affected by COVID-19. I'm encouraged that President Biden's Build Back Better agenda gives us the opportunity as a nation to address longstanding inequities and provide each student with the resources and supports they need to thrive. This is our moment to ensure students can achieve their dreams, particularly those our systems have not always served well. Together, let's give our learners a bright future filled with limitless possibilities. Let's build back better than ever before in South Carolina and across America. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Secretary Cardona, for your affirming and inspiring remarks. It is such an honor to have you here with us today. As Secretary Riley mentioned, I'm Kathy Stevens, and I'm the director of the Riley Institute's What Works South Carolina Clearinghouse. It is truly wonderful to be online with all of you today, celebrating South Carolina's public schools and public educators. I believe I can speak for all of us attending this event when I say, goodness, our educators deserve more recognition, gratitude, and encouragement than ever before. What a time they have been living and working through. Our educators are indeed saints among us. At the same time, we also want to take a moment this year to celebrate and thank the parents of our public school students. Many of these parents have also served as educators in the past 2 years, and now more than ever, we recognize the deep value of educator-parent partnership and collaboration in helping all of our students receive a world-class education. I'd like to extend a special welcome to the elected officials who are joining us today. Thank you all for taking the time to be with us and for your leadership in supporting public education in South Carolina. I'd also like to welcome the school superintendents who are here with us today. Your leadership in guiding our school districts to offer high quality education to our students, particularly during this complex and persistent pandemic, is critical. So thank you all for being here. In a few minutes, we will learn a little bit more about the individual programs we celebrate today and some of the key strategies that lead to their success. Please offer congratulations and share positive vibes in the chat box. This really is meant to be a celebration. We hope you'll share takeaways and thoughts on social media later using the hashtag WhatWorksSC. Before we move into talking about the individual programs, I'd like to tell you just a little bit about this annual award. The WhatWorksSC Award is presented in recognition of the legacy of our friend and South Carolina's former education governor, Dick Riley, and is dedicated to the memory of Ann Tunkey Riley, a devoted teacher and passionate advocate for quality public education for all children. As governor and First Lady of South Carolina, Dick and Tunkey energetically supported students and teachers alike, and we thank them so much. Secretary Riley, we are ever so glad to have this unique opportunity to remember wonderful Tunkey and to honor your never-ending dedication to public education in our state. So how did we choose today's finalists? Each spring, the Riley Institute accepts applications for the WhatWorksSC Award. These applications come from schools and community-based education programs that are grounded in sound research and have collected local data demonstrating effectiveness. The Riley Institute's Center for Education Policy and Leadership team evaluates those applications using a rubric and narrows the pool to 8 to 10 programs. The top programs are then sent to a confidential, nonpartisan selection committee comprising 5 state and national education experts. This committee scores the programs based on the same rubric and determines the winner and 2 finalists. It is never an easy job because we have so many wonderful applicants each year for the award. I'd like to offer a special thank you to our selection committee who carefully reviewed and scored the finalists this year. All 3 of the finalists are then added to the WhatWorksSC Clearinghouse on the Riley Institute's website. The finalists and winning programs are also added to knowitall.org, an online resource for educators as part of the Riley Institute's partnership with South Carolina ETV. If any of that did not make sense, or if you have any questions at all, please email me, Kathy Stevens, about the process and how to apply. And please be thinking about programs that should apply in the spring of 2022. Our application window will open in the middle of March. Now I invite you to join me in a brief slideshow highlighting our gallery of winners from the past 10 years. There are no models or actors in these images. Each person you will see has been a real participant in a WhatWorksSC award-winning program, and we are excited to celebrate their success along with each program's success. Let's take a look.
The Center for Educator Recruitment, Retention, and Advancement South Carolina Teaching Fellows.
Clemson University's Reading Recovery Training Center.
Chester Park Elementary School of Inquiry's Project-Based Learning Initiative.
Francis Marion University's Center of Excellence to Prepare Teachers of Children of Poverty.
The Center for Educator Recruitment, Retention, and Advancement's Teacher Cadet Program.
Healing Species.
Public Education Partners Make Summer Count.
Prisma Health's Grow to Greatness, formerly known as Farm to Belly.
The University of South Carolina's Carolina Teacher Induction Program.
Spartanburg First Steps Quality Counts.
We are delighted to have representatives from these programs joining us this afternoon. Thank you to these programs and their leaders for continuing to do such great work in the state. We truly commend you. Every year at this celebration, we at the Riley Institute cherish the opportunity to shine a bright light on all of the great things happening in South Carolina public education. Today, we are thrilled to tell you about this year's three finalists and share a video with you about each of them. It has been our pleasure to work with SCETV for all 11 years of this program to create videos about the outstanding, hardworking finalists. Thank you, SCETV, for this meaningful partnership. Our first finalist is the Bridges to a Brighter Future program in Greenville. Bridges to a Brighter Future provides long-term, need-based support to promising high school students who live in communities that are traditionally underrepresented in higher education and helps them on their path to college. Among the students who participate in the program, 92% enter college or the military directly after high school, compared to the national average of 54% among students from a similar background. Let's watch their video.
If you look at Bridges on paper, it may just look like a college access program, but it's so much more. Our belief is that an education is a key to a better life.
You know, we recognize that exposure to opportunities broadens horizons, and that's something that we want to do for our students.
Bridges is a program that works with students across Greenville County starting in ninth grade and helping them become the person they want to be through education. Our ultimate goal is that they graduate from college and build the life that they want to build. To be in Bridges, our students come from some challenging backgrounds. The way we look at it is we have students who have experienced and thrived through some of the most challenging experiences that anyone could go through, but they have seen something spark, something that they want more. And we take these students and work with them all the way through high school, all the way through college, not only building math, science, writing, reading skills, but leadership development, how you can take care of yourself, how the mind and body are connected. We make sure that they have their needs met. We can't expect them to thrive, so we got to make sure as a community we're helping these students thrive. And that's what Bridges is. It's a community trying to make sure that all together we work and help our tomorrow, our students who are going to be leading us tomorrow, help them get where they need to go.
We have this saying at Bridges that we're a community, we're a family, and a lot of our students and staff and faculty will refer to that as Bridges love.
Bridges is like a home away from home to me. It's like a family where you can come together to help each other with anything.
It's given me skills like being a better person internally and a better person externally.
Bridges is basically home. It's a second home, it's a second family. And what we do is they make me a better person.
They saw that I was worth more than I can see in myself my freshman year. And now I know my worth. I know that I can and will be my best self in this world.
Director Carrie Silver and Assistant Director for High School Success, Dean Bailey, are with us today, along with several Bridges to a Brighter Future students who are currently attending Furman University. You can see them with me on the screen now. They are joining us from Greenville. Will y'all give us a wave? Congratulations on being a 2021 What Works SC Award finalist. Our second finalist is Charleston Promise Neighborhood. Charleston Promise Neighborhood partners with under-resourced early learning and elementary schools in Charleston to co-design strategies to improve academic and social outcomes for students and their families through school day supports and after-school programming. Let's take a look.
Charleston Promise Neighborhood is a nonprofit organization that was founded in 2010 to support a specific neighborhood called The Neck in Charleston. We provide services that support children, that strengthens families, and mobilize residents to action.
Charleston Promise Neighborhood is like a part of the family. They're integrally involved. They understand that collaboration is really strong because they are in the building. They see what we need.
Charleston Promise Neighborhood works. It facilitates other partners to be involved with our students and with the neighbors, the people that make up our neighborhood. It does a wonderful job about bringing people together to solve problems. A child can't learn if the child is not well, so we make sure that the child and the family now have medical services. We concentrate primarily on education. So our motto, our goal, our mission is transformation within a generation so that the Charleston Promise neighborhood will look like any other neighborhood in the Charleston area within the next generation.
Everything starts with a foundation. If you have high quality services and wraparound services for a school, a classroom, in a community, it's a building block and you should see smaller achievement gap.
CPN provided the after school program for us, which is free to our families. CPN has allowed our parents to work longer and be able to provide for their families.
So Charleston Promise Neighborhood is vitally important because we connect the dots. To ensure that students have all of the wraparound supports they need. We help connect the dots to ensure that principals have a thought partner in implementing those strategies in the schools that they serve, and we, in some instances, help to provide some of the fuel that helps them go and soar, and also that the community has a friend in an organization like Charleston Promise Neighborhood so that we can elevate what engagement looks and feels like and the results of community efforts that we are part of making those things real and tangible and impactfully in our community.
We are excited to have CEO Sherry Snipes Williams with us online today, who is joined by representatives of her philanthropy, operations, and programs teams. Will y'all give us a wave? Congratulations on being a 2021 What Works SC Award finalist. Our third finalist today is Reading Partners South Carolina, also based in Charleston. Reading Partners places community volunteers in low-income schools to help children master basic reading through individualized one-on-one tutoring. By working to improve reading comprehension, reading fluency, and sight word reading, the program helps put participants on track to read on grade level by the end of third grade. Let's watch a video about this special program.
I really believe in the power of reading, and I also believe that the ability to read, it should not be dictated by the zip code where you are born into. So I believe that every student across the state, that those students that we work with in these under-resourced schools should grow up really with a love of reading. Reading Partners South Carolina is a community-driven, evidence-based literacy tutoring program. We recruit community volunteers to come into under-resourced elementary schools to work one-on-one with our students twice a week.
As a special project manager, my job is to be a support system for AmeriCorps members as they come in and complete a service year. Reading Partners is important to students because they're able to take what they've learned in Reading Partners, working with their reading partner, and they're able to transfer those skills into their actual classroom.
In South Carolina, 4 out of 5 fourth grade students are not reading proficiently at grade level. So there's a real need for this program across the state, especially in our underserved populations, our Title I schools, our students who are living in really marginalized communities. We work with kindergarten through fifth grade, depending on the needs of the school, and every student is seen one-on-one at least twice a week.
We've seen a lot of success with implementing Reading Partners here at Hersey. We have seen increase in students' gains, both in not only just their reading phonemical awareness as well as comprehension, but also their social emotional impact we've seen from this as well. Students are happy, they're learning, they feel more confident, and we attribute that to Reading Partners.
If students are not reading on grade level by the time they exit fourth grade, there's an 88% chance that they will never catch up. So we really have kind of a small window of opportunity to make sure that they are exactly where they need to be. So for future success in school, as well as in our communities.
I think Reading Partners is about like to learn how to read and just like help kids. If I don't know the word, they say sound it out.
My favorite part about working with reading partners is seeing that smile on the student's face when they actually accomplish something. They're building that self-confidence so that they too will have a passion and a love for reading.
Senior Executive Director Keisha Greenhouse, Special Projects Manager Sierra Rogers, and Regional Board Chair Emily Swanson join us online today to celebrate. Will you guys give us a wave? Congratulations on being a 2021 What Works SC Award finalist. Now I would like to turn the program over to the Riley Institute's founding and executive director, Dr. Don Gordon. Don?
Thank you, Kathy, and congratulations to all three programs for making a huge difference for the children of South Carolina. We love learning about all of you over the past few months. It is my great pleasure to introduce our keynote speaker today, South Carolina Superintendent of Education Molly Spearman. Our state has been incredibly fortunate to have Superintendent Spearman leading our public education system since 2015. Her career as an educator and administrator prepared her well for this role. Consider this. Superintendent Spearman spent 18 years serving as a classroom music teacher and assistant principal. She then served 6 years as Deputy Superintendent of South Carolina Department of Education and 10 years as the Executive Director of the South Carolina Association of School Administrators. She's also been on the legislative side of things, having served 4 terms as a member of the South Carolina House of Representatives. I'd also like to add that Superintendent Spearman is a great friend of the Riley Institute. A 2012 graduate of our Diversity Leaders Initiative, she embraces public education, diversity, and collaboration as the fundamental elements of civil society. She's with us today to tell us about South Carolina's recent decision to make a huge investment in the arts with American Rescue Plan funding. We're tremendously excited about the potential benefit of engaging students creatively through the arts, especially for students recovering from COVID-19 related unfinished learning. Superintendent, thanks so much for being with us today.
Well, good afternoon, Don, and everyone. Thank you so much for the special introduction. And I'm so appreciative of the work that you and your team at the Riley Institute has and continues to do to support educational programs across South Carolina. And I'm especially thankful for my dear friend, former governor and secretary, Dick Riley, for his lifetime of dedication to education in our state. Governor Riley, I'm actually down at the CCSSO meeting in Florida, and everyone here, the state chiefs from all across the nation, say hello to you, and they're still very thankful for your leadership. The last 19 months have been the most demanding and stressful that students, families, educators have faced in their lives and careers. So to all of you teachers, principals, district staff members, parents, grandparents, community members, we've all been in it together, watching from home, thank you. Thank you for your commitment, perseverance, patience, as we navigate the ever-changing conditions brought on by this global pandemic. State education agencies and school districts across the country have been blessed with a transformational amount of funding from the federal government to help students and educators rebound from COVID-19. This influx of funding and the challenges brought on are exacerbated by the pandemic present a unique opportunity for our state to be forward-thinking and expand proven programs statewide to support struggling learners. As many of you know, I served as a classroom music teacher for over 20 years and have seen firsthand the impact that the arts can have on students of diverse backgrounds and how we can use the arts to bolster instruction in other core subject matters, such as reading and math. There is no stronger avenue to build the skills and characteristics, creativity, perseverance, problem solving, that our business community always talks about that they need in our graduates. No better place to do that than through the arts. I'm a big believer. So when the South Carolina Arts Commission brought us the idea of using proven arts-based education initiatives as a way to accelerate learning during the school day and also through summer and after-school programs, I was elated to be in a position to say, absolutely, yes. So our partnership, which amounts to over $20 million in funding over the next 3 years, is known as the Arts Grow South Carolina. And it is the largest such partnership in the United States. Through Arts Grow SC, we will expand existing evidence-based programs such as the ABC Project and Engaging Creative Mind Theme Camps, while also developing new programs, including those that build capacity in classrooms, schools, and districts to sustain their own art-based education initiatives. A grant component will allow us to support program practices, and research and evaluations will help us build new measures for evaluating the impact of the arts in our efforts. I encourage all of you today who are listening to visit artsgrowsc.org, learn more, and see how you can get involved. And I'd be remiss if I didn't mention another partnership born out of this COVID-19 pandemic. Last week, along with the Riley Institute team, we were proud to announce the $1.3 million investment to establish the South Carolina After School Leaders Empowered Program, SCALE, S-C-A-L-E, to prepare and grow leaders who are working to address the academic impact of COVID-19 through summer and after school learning programs. SCALE will convene a diverse cohort 20 emerging summer and after-school learning leaders each year for 3 years. Participants will be leaders who work in school districts or are members of community organizations that are partnering with school districts to provide evidence-based after-school and summer learning for students who are in need of additional support outside of the normal school day. I've long maintained that educators cannot prepare every student for success alone. We need lots of partners like you. That's true now more than ever. We need your support, the support of our state and community partners to address the diverse needs of our students. The Dick and Tunkey Riley Virtual What Works SC Award honors these programs that have delivered results, and all our finalists today are well deserving. Thank you again for allowing me to be with you today and to serve as your state superintendent of education, the highest honor of my life. I'll turn it back to you, Secretary Riley, to announce the winner.
Thank you so much to my friend, Superintendent Molly Spearman. And my sincere thanks for your effective leadership in a real challenging time for education in so many ways. You mentioned after school program. That's so important for South Carolina. And then also to mention your love of arts learning, being engaged in the arts. I've always believed that education in music and the arts is so critical to the success of our students. So I thank you for your leadership in both of those important areas and so many others. Thank you so much. Now, just a few moments, the finalists will join me on the screen, which, as you know, in COVID version, that's the stage. So they're going to join me on the screen as I proceed to announce our winner. Again, I'm so pleased to have this chance to recognize and celebrate the positive things happening in education in our great state. I'm proud of everyone who is watching today, and especially our finalists. I'm so impressed by the excellent work you and your team. It takes a team, really, people working together as finalists for this award. It's an award that makes me proud, honoring me and my dear wife, Tucky Riley, who passed away in 2008. And I still consider her to be the greatest ever champion of quality education for all children. I'm so proud of Tucky. I'm proud that she's mentioned in this award. And today, each of our finalists is joined by a Riley Institute staff leader. Our executive director, Don Gordon, is with Reading Partners in Charleston. Our deputy director, Jackie Martin, accompanies Charleston Promise Neighborhood. And our research director, Brooke Colcasia, is the Bridges to a Brighter Future here in Greenville. So at this time, I invite Don and Jackie and Brooke to hold up the beautiful crystal award to be given to all three of our finalists. Thank you. And they will present it to each finalist after I announce the winner of the 2021 Dick and Tucky Riley What Works South Carolina Award of Excellence. It is my pleasure now to announce the winner, Reading Partners South Carolina. Congratulations to you all very much.
My pleasure to give this 2021 What Works South Carolina's Dick and Tucky Riley Award for Reading Partners South Carolina.
Thank you so much. Yes. Wow, we are blown away and so privileged to be part of this excellent group of finalists, our neighbors, Charleston Promise Neighborhood, who we do a lot of work with in the past and probably will in the future, as well as the Great Bridges program that we've just heard about. So thank you so much. And thank you, Superintendent Spearman, and to the Riley Institute, and to Dick Riley, and of course, in honor of his lovely wife.
Folks, join me in congratulating all of our finalists.
Good job. Congratulations.
Great job.
Congratulations.
Thanks for all you do. Thank you.
Congratulations. That's great.
I'm so proud of all three finalists, and congratulations to Bridges to a Brighter Future, Charleston Promise Neighborhood, and Reading Partners South Carolina. I appreciate the work you do day in and day out. Our students and their families appreciate it all too. You're building a better, more informed South Carolina for us all. So let's please give another round of applause for our finalists.
Congratulations, everybody.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Again, I'm so proud and grateful to all of you for participating in our What Works Award and celebration. So on behalf of myself, Don, Jackie, Kathy, and all the folks at the Riley Institute, sincere thanks to the thousands of dedicated staff and volunteers who contribute to the success of these initiatives to provide high-quality education for all South Carolina students. I'm so proud of Kathy's presentation about the clearinghouse. That is the way that everybody in the state, whatever school, whatever group is trying to improve their education, can look at these wonderful ideas and get a good example of something that they can copy and emulate. And that is so good right on. They have that right on, and please use that as much as you can. So I thank you, Kathy, for that. Now I encourage everyone to please spread the word about these three finalists, Bridges to a Brighter Future, Charleston Promise Neighborhood, and Reading Partners South Carolina. We want our legislators, our friends, our colleagues, and our families to know that there's a lot of good happening in South Carolina education. And so we hope to see you next year for What Works South Carolina 2022. Meanwhile, please keep up the good work and please stay safe. Thank you so much.